Hello dear learners, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Shobhit Vadva, Associate Professor, Ideal Institute of Management and Technology, Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Delhi. The module we will be discussing today is on the topic Integration of ICT-Aided Constructivist Approach in Education. And the objectives of the module are to understand the concept of constructivist approach and integration of ICT. Secondly, to highlight the various issues of integrating ICT-aided constructivist approach in education, along with to enumerate the paradigm shifts in education to explore ICT-aided constructivist approach and to focus the various concerns of ICT-aided constructivist approach. Friends, constructivism, it is a learning theory found in psychology, which explains how people might learn and acquire knowledge. It therefore has direct application to education. Constructivism is not a specific pedagogy. It is a theory suggesting that humans construct knowledge and meaning from their experiences. Piaget's theory of constructivist learning has had wide-ranging impact on learning theories and teaching methods in education, and is an underlying theme of many education reform movements. Research support for constructivist teaching techniques has been mixed, with some research supporting these techniques and other research contradicting those results. Vygotsky has stated the importance of constructivism by saying that through others we become ourselves. This statement emphasizes the importance of social interaction with people, which enhances the learning. Von Glaserfeld has described constructivism as a theory of knowledge with roots in philosophy, psychology, and cybernetics. Constructivism does not claim to have made earth-shaking inventions in the area of education. It merely claims to provide a solid conceptual basis for some of the things that until now inspired teachers had to do without theoretical foundation. Constructivism suggests that the learner's understandings of the way the words work is the result of one's own active construction rather than someone else's presentation. Constructivists believes that knowledge is the result of individual constructions of reality. It is believed that learning process coupled with digital technology may bring educational systems into alignment with the emerging knowledge-based information-rich and technologically advanced society. Information and communication technology, referred as ICT, it provides students with swift access to new information. Its reasonable application can make teaching more diversified, flexible, and effective. It facilitates problem solving and offers learning tools which can develop critical thinking among the learners. New information technologies, and particularly internet, are dramatically transforming access to information, hence changing the learning and research process. How we search, discover, how we teach, how we learn. ICT offers wide array for building new schooling systems that allows long distance exchange and interaction between geographically spread groups of teachers and their students. Meeting this challenge in turn requires collaboration across national, cultural, and institutional boundaries and among groups and individuals who have been isolated. With their increasingly ubiquitous presence within and outside the school, the information and communication technology have begun to challenge what schools try to teach and the whole basis of assessing the knowledge and skills that students acquire. ICT in schools, therefore, has a strong rationale and is natural sequence in the evolution of the schooling process. It is only with new skills and perceptions that a teacher can assume his or her new role as a facilitator of learning and implement and maintain innovations in classroom. There are volumes of writings and epistemological foundations on techno-constructivism. Theoretically, it has sound philosophy, roots and stems, but still it needs to blossom and bloom through practices and research. The philosophy of learning of the people, including learners, teachers, administrators, parents and the whole society coming under the education sector is still static. It needs transformation. It is evident at the lab level that the ICT-aided constructivism is significantly effective, yet it needs a grassroots theory for practical utility at the operational level. Practically implementing the ICT-aided constructivist learning approach in the classroom setting has several issues. Let us discuss them one by one. Friends, in the Indian context, the classroom environment is not conducive to the implementation of ICT-aided constructive learning approach. The class size is big, and managing this form of learning would be difficult in such a big class. Also, there is a shortage of trained teachers, and also the trained teacher educators in the area of ICT-aided constructive learning approach. Teachers are required to be trained to use constructivism and cognitive tools and techniques well enough in order to facilitate their use by their students. Teachers have to develop new teaching skills. The teacher's role has to be changed from that of purveyor of knowledge to instigator, promoter, coach, helper, model, and guide of knowledge construction. Writing and scoring assessments of high-order thinking is new and difficult to the teachers. If these tools are used to engage constructive, self-regulated, critical, creative and complex thinking, then teachers are obligated to assess those kinds of constructive outcomes and not reproductive learning. Again, there is shortage of trained administrators in the area of ICT-aided constructive learning approach. Committed teachers are not enough if the political leaders and school administrators are not themselves committed to build a new thinking school culture. Enough time must be given to help students develop their thinking skills. There must be adequate administrative support. Along with that, support from parents, that is very important. Parent understanding and support is very much required for this. While all parents espouse the importance of constructive, self-regulated and critical thinking as important learning outcomes, most parents are more interested in comparing their children's grades than in understanding what their children are learning and experiencing. There is a lack of minimum facilities of information and communication technology, which is also a major issue in this respect. Also, rigid disciplined classroom setting like infrastructure, sitting arrangement are disrespecting the independency of the learners. The educational software which facilitate positive learning are not widely available, and development of the fully functional software by the learners and teachers demand training. Constructivism seems to pass the onus of creating the knowledge to the student. It is highly desirable but relatively challenging. We usually have less faith in the learners to be the discoverers of their own learning and creator of the meaning of learning. To prevent constructivism from turning into a crudely relativistic form of constructionism, which is likely to offend on psychological, ethical and political grounds, we need to ensure that the fruits of students' construct are linked appropriately to that which qualifies as genuine knowledge from the perspectives of experts within the real-world disciplines. So, to realize the dream of integrating ICT with constructivist approach in education, the issues we discussed need to be looked upon sincerely. Let us recall the issues. Classroom environment is not conducive. lack of trained teachers and teacher educators, lack of minimum facilities of ICT, and disrespecting the independency of the learners. Now let us proceed ahead. It is evident that students come to any learning situation with knowledge about learning as well as prior knowledge in the content area, beliefs, abilities, motivations, and personality traits as personal presage factors. These personal characteristics interact with the learning environment to produce a context-specific motivation to engage in a particular learning experience. This means that students read the learning environment, particularly the assessment requirements, and subsequently choose a strategy that parallels the learning motive for that particular context. So, learning context should be set according to all the beliefs, abilities, and motivations of the learners. Not all learning materials should be considered as instructional materials. Constructivist approach emphasizes different kinds of learning, feature different kinds of methods, and are rooted in different epistemological frameworks. If we seek systems that support other kinds of learning, then we need to better differentiate methods according to their consistency with various perspectives. For constructivist learning environment, it is important to understand how the core epistemological beliefs can be reconciled with or necessarily depart from other design practices. Now let us discuss some prominent paradigm shifts needed in education to implement ICT-aided constructivist learning approach. First is reproductive learning to productive learning. Friends, earlier, learners' achievements were measured against their ability to reproduce the subject content. In other words, how well they could memorize and reproduce the content that the teacher transferred to them. With the emphasis on productive learning, it is rather about the application of knowledge and skills. In other words, what the learners can do after completing the learning process. Achievement is measured against the productive contribution a learner can make instead of what the learner can reproduce. We also talk about teacher-centered to learner-centered. The traditional educational activities strongly focused on preferences and teaching style of the teacher, which would work best for the teacher, determined the design of the learning environment and the nature of learning activities. From all these, the preferences should shift to learner-centered learning. The learning environment should be designed according to the needs and possibilities of particular learner group. Let us see the various differences in this teacher-centered learning environment and learner-centered learning environment. If we talk about the classroom activity in teacher-centered learning environment is more teacher-centered and didactic, while in learner-centered learning environment, it is learner-centered and interactive. If we talk in regards to the teacher's role, he is a fact teller, an expert in teacher-centered learning environment, while he is a collaborator and sometimes a learner in learner-centered learning environment. If we talk about the instructional emphasis in teacher-centered environment, fact memorization is the main form of instruction, while relationships building, inquiry, and invention are more focused upon in learner-centered environment. The concepts of knowledge are accumulation of facts and quantity of knowledge that is focused and looked upon in teacher-centered environment, while we focus on the transformation of facts in learner-centered environment. If we talk about the demonstration of success or the assessment, the norm referenced success is measured in teacher-centered environment, while we focus on the quality of understanding in learner-centered environment. The assessment is also varied, like in teacher-centered environment, multiple choice items are usually preferred, while in learner-centered, criterion-referenced portfolios, etc. are more focused. When we talk about in terms of technology usage, in teacher learning-centered environment, drill and practice is majorly used, while in learner-centered environment, we basically use communication, access, collaboration, and expression. Now, moving ahead, we come to the teaching to learning facilitation. Teaching is seen as an activity that relates to the transfer of content within a teaching-centered education paradigm. From this didactic environment to learning facilitation, learning-centered education paradigm should be followed. Teachers cannot be regarded as the only source of knowledge and cannot focus on the transfer of content method any longer. They need to focus on the facilitation of learning. Teachers cannot be considered as the fountainhead of information, since the technology can provide students with access to an infinite amount of array of data and information. The role of instructor, therefore, changes to learning facilitator. The instructor facilitates the environment so that the learner can access, synthesize, and interpret it and draw the meaning out of it. The role of teacher has shifted from knowledge transmitter, primary source of information, content expert, and source of all answers to learning facilitator, collaborator, coach, mentor, knowledge navigator, and co-learner. If we talk about the shift from content-based to outcome-based, the emphasis from content-based teaching learning has now shifted to outcome-based, that is, reaching the prior set learning objectives meaningfully after the learning process. The product-oriented has been shifted to process-oriented approach. In constructivist learning, the process is considered as the heart of the learning. The emphasis is much on the process of learning, that how we learn instead of what we learn. How the learners come to conclusion, how they relate the concepts to the prior concepts and scaffold the relationships between the ideas, and finally, how they draw the meaning important rather than scoring high on achievement test, which would be held at the end of the session. If we talk about assessment, the content-based evaluation has shifted to outcome-based assessment. Here, rather than highlighting on the evaluation of what content has been there in the syllabus, teachers should assess outcome through transformation in terms of skills and applications along with knowledge and understanding. Knowledge production has also shifted to knowledge configuration, as there is fast development in the field of ICT, increasing amount of information is available and accessible from all parts of the world. The days when information and knowledge were limited to libraries, books, and experts are over. Knowledge production is making room for so-called knowledge configuration. Over 90% of the knowledge produced globally is not produced where its use is required. The challenge is how to get knowledge that might have been produced anywhere in the world to the place where it can be used effectively in a particularly problem-solving context. So, all these paradigm shifts in education have contributed to ever-growing need to innovate our educational practice and to explore new learning paradigms like ICT-aided constructivist learning approach. Let us have a look on these paradigms once again. Reproductive to productive learning, teacher-centered to learner-centered, teaching to learning facilitation, content-based to outcome-based, product oriented to process oriented, and content based evaluation to outcome based evaluation, along with knowledge production to knowledge configuration. ICTs are exerting impacts on pedagogical approaches in the classrooms. Their contribution to changes in teaching practices, school innovation, and community services is considerable. ICT is becoming more fitting to realize and implement the emerging pedagogy of constructivism. As already discussed, it focuses on learner-centered learning in following ways. Active learning. ICT enhanced learning mobilizes tools for examination, calculation, and analysis of information in order to provide a platform for student inquiry, analysis, and construction of new information. The learners therefore learn as they do and whenever appropriate work on real life problems in depth. Moreover, ICT makes the learning less abstract and more relevant to their life situations. In contrast to memorization based or rote learning, that is the feature of traditional pedagogy, ICT enhanced learning promotes increased learner engagement. ICT enhanced learning can also be just in time learning, that the learners choose what to learn when they need. Collaborative learning. ICT supported learning encourages interaction and cooperation among students, teachers, and experts, regardless of where they are. Apart from modeling real-world interactions, ICT-supported learning provides opportunity to work with students from different cultures, thereby helping to enhance learners' learning and communication skills as well as their global awareness. If we talk about creative learning, ICT-supported learning promotes the manipulation of existing information and the creation of real-world products rather than duplication of received information. It also enhances integrative learning. It promotes a thematic integrative approach to teaching and learning. This approach eliminates the artificial separation between the different disciplines and between theory and practice, which characterizes the traditional approach. Evaluation and evaluative learning. ICT enhanced learning is student directed and diagnostic. Unlike static text or print based education, ICT enhanced learning recognizes the presence of different learning pathways to explore and discover rather than merely listen and remember. In this way, ICT aids constructivist approach by making learning not only learning, but active learning, creative learning, collaborative learning, integrative learning, and evaluative learning. The web is where constructivist learning can take place. The web provides access to rich sources of information, encourages meaningful interactions with content, and brings people together to challenge, support, or respond to each other. However, merely providing students with access to the web does not guarantee constructivist learning. The lecturer or instructor is required to provide some guidance or coaching to allow students to create their own meanings. The real classroom setting should be made favorable to implement ICT-aided constructive learning approach. Now, we will discuss the concerns towards implementing ICT-aided constructivist learning approach. A buffer should be maintained between the learner and potentially damaging effects of instructional practices. Emphasis should be given to the affective domain also and make instruction relevant to the learner. Learners should be helped to develop attitudes and beliefs that support both present learning and lifelong learning. Context should be provided for both autonomous learning and learning within relationships among students, such as group discussion, projection, collaboration, as well as independent construction. Balance needs to be established and maintained in teacher control with personal autonomy in the learning environment. Reasons for learning should be provided within the learning activities themselves. Skills and attitudes should be promoted to enable a learner to assume responsibility for his or her cognitive and developmental processes. Strategic exploration of errors should be used to strengthen the learner involvement with intentional learning processes and self-feedback. There should be availability of ICT facilities and creation of online community. Research should be done rigorously on constructivist learning approach and ICT enhanced constructivist learning approach. Innovations in learning that we expect should focus on personalized and adaptive learning, dynamic monitoring systems, and integrating experience-based learning into the classroom. In order for any discipline to survive, it must accommodate changes in theory and practice and do so in a way that adds value to the discipline. It was quoted by Kuhn in 1972. The constructivist view of the world gives new status to the learner as active agent of learning. Constructivist pedagogy offers a bold departure from traditional classroom strategies. The goal is for the learner to play an active role in assimilating knowledge into one's existing cognitive structure. The constructivist approach requires the teacher to relinquish one's role as sole information dispenser and instead to continually analyze one's curriculum planning and instructional methodologies. At the same time, there are various new demands on the part of teachers. Constructivism is a culture, not a fragmented collection of practices. Crafting instruction based on constructivism is not as straightforward as it seems. It could be developed as a culture of the class. New insights don't happen by osmosis. They come from facing ideas that challenge the familiar ways of viewing issues. Constructivism must be an extension and not a mere replacement for high quality curriculum. To sum up, we can say that out of all the difficulties to implement the ICT-aided constructivist learning approach in the real class settings, there is a ray of rhythm reflecting that one day this approach would find its grounded design and it will be possible to implement it successfully in all the real classroom settings and environment. Thank you.